Hey guys, what's up? So here's my new design. Check this out. It is not a grasshopper, it's a cricket. And not just any cricket. Check this out. Want to learn how to fold it? Ready, set, here goes. All right, so for this model, I'm going to use a 6-inch square of Connie. So let's begin white side up and fold and unfold in half in all directions. Make sure to make really precise folds and crease sharply. Now this model is really complex, so if you're new to folding, I don't know if I'd recommend this. I mean, it's an insect and there's a couple sinks, but if you're up for the challenge, well, let's continue. Now fold all four corners to the middle. And unfold. And now fold the bottom edge to the crease. And rotate and repeat on this side. Now turn over and rotate and fold the bottom edge to the crease. And repeat on this side. Okay, now reach into this pocket, stick your finger in there, and flatten it like this. And repeat on this side. And do the same thing on top. And turn over and fold in half. Okay, now rotate, and holding the layers together, let's fold this edge to the middle. And repeat on this side. And unfold those flaps. And now fold these flaps up. We're folding on this point, and we're folding it so that these corners land on this crease. And repeat on this side. Now unfold these flaps, and now we're going to rabbit ear. So fold them to the crease like this, and just pinch right there, and unfold. And now fold them so that these edges align with the crease. And pinch like that, and unfold, and now pinch it and flatten it to the right. And repeat on this side. Okay, now turn over and fold this flap on the crease like this. And same on this side. Trying to hold the layers together. Okay, so these are gonna be the front legs, all four, although you only see two, and we have to thin them. So let's first fold this edge to this edge. And same on this side. All right, now comes a challenging step. Let's unfold and unfold here, and we're going to sink this in. So here we have a triangle. One, two, and we need the third edge. Let's do that right now. So just pinch there and pinch on this crease and this crease. And now we have our triangle and we just need to push the middle in. So this is an open sink. Well, we're closing it now. It's going to be a closed open sink. So pinch it like that. And close it. So it's like that. So there is the sink completed. Now let's repeat on this side. Okay, now we're going to separate the two legs. So first, lift up this front flap, and that'll let you be able to grab the other one. So we can separate the flaps and just, we're really sliding out this flap. So just slide it out. So it's about like that. So this edge touches this point. And repeat on this side. So it's like that. And now open these flaps and bring this flap up and close them. Paper airplane fold. Okay, now fold this layer over this edge. And do the same on this side. And squash it down like this, as far down as it goes. And now fold this flap up on these two points. I'll try to go a little bit farther. Okay, that's more even. And now lift this flap up as you close these flaps. So it's like that. And now fold this flap between this point and this point. And same on this side. Okay, now fold in half and reach in and pull this flap out like that. Now while we're here, let's shape the head and legs. So now fold this down so that it just goes down like this. So the points just poke out the bottom and fold them back up to make tiny little feet. Same on this side. Okay, so the front of the model is basically complete. Now let's work on the rear. So open these flaps and fold this flap behind, and now fold this edge to here and pinch here so it's a rabbit ear, like that, and same on this side. Okay, now we're going to make a reverse fold. Well, let's first fold in half a little bit like this, and now fold this big thick flap on these two existing creases. So we're reverse folding it. So it's like that. And now turn over and let's do a rabbit ear on this flap. So let's pinch these two edges together. And flatten it upward. Like that. And repeat. Okay, now comes a fun step. We're going to change this fold. We're going to alter it so it goes from here to the corner. And when we do that, check this out. It slides the paper out. And this is the hind leg. Let's continue it. So we're going to change the fold so that it goes all the way to the corner. And you can make it as thin as you want. So it's like that. And repeat. Okay, now we're going to try to close this up. Wow, that's a big portion of white. That's okay though, it's underneath. So now we're going to reverse fold this big hunky flap and fold it right at this point so that it's even with this point. And we want to try to get this edge to be sort of lined up with this edge. And same on this side. Okay, so that's what the reverse fold looks like. Now we're going to try to thin out the hind legs. So let's fold this edge to the middle, like that. And now continue it up like this. So that's one reverse fold. And repeat. Okay, so there are the reverse folds. Now we can thin it out up here by just folding this edge behind, lining it up with this. We just want to give the illusion that, at least at the end, that this whole hind leg is separate. So we can also thin it out right here. Just kind of sculpt it so that it's nice and thin. Like that. And repeat. All right, so to make this thing hop, you just wanna press it down. And I guess I shouldn't zoom out. You wanna press it and make sure you don't land on the leg, because it's not gonna hop if you land it on the leg or on the tail. So you just wanna go right in the middle. So you end up right behind the tail. Okay, so here goes. Now I'm gonna zoom out. That went forward. Let's try that again. Yeah, that went pretty far forward. Now, if you want it to go more up and down, then you can just kind of push it like this, so it's more inward. That way, it'll go up more. Let's see. Yeah, that went up. Yeah, that really hopped. There, and landed on his legs. All right, so there you have it. Hope you guys found this interesting. I think it's a really cool model. I mean, I've never seen a hopping insect before in origami, so I think this is pretty cool. Hope you guys like it, and I'll see you guys later.